Hi, I'm Jack Koenig with Graco Industrial Lubrication Equipment, and this is the Air Over Oil Manifold for MSP. We offer this manifold for 3-section, 4-section, 5-section, and 6-section MSP assemblies, so it can go up to 12 points. It can also go down to as low as 1 point, but that's a little bit trickier. That's how I have this set up right now. These two aren't actually connected. I'll show you how to do that in a little bit, but first let's talk about how this air over oil manifold actually works. Another note, this is an E-series setup, but you can also do what I'm gonna show you with a G3 pump. The G3 oil pump, the E-series pump, a ModuFlow, there's a lot of other pumps that can pump oil that would work with the air over oil manifold. So let's take a look at how this air over oil manifold works. If you've ever been up to Anoka for training, or if you've seen us at a trade show, you've probably seen one of these acrylic MSP valves that we use to demonstrate the internal workings. Here we have one of the valves removed so that we can see the side of the valve, but then also get a good look at the base. So I'm going to go through how the valve and the base interact, and just pay attention that I'm going to talk about this valve and I'm going to talk about this base. But in reality, this valve feeds the base below it. The air over oil manifold connects to the indicator ports on an MSP valve. To understand how the manifold works, we first need to understand how the indicators work. When we put a performance indicator on this port, pressure feeds directly up from the outlets of the MSP valve. Here is the path down to the outlets. That's the path that goes through the valve itself. Now let's look at the base. In the base, you can see this is the hole that connected to the other one we were looking at, and the hole connects directly to the outlet. It's actually on the outlet side of the internal check valve. See the little ball in the spring there? The check ball is actually upstream of where the performance indicator would usually connect. So with a performance indicator, when there's too much back pressure, it pushes up into the indicator port and then it activates the indicator, whether it be a reset where the pin pops out or an auto relief where you get some oil or grease squirting out of it. In the case of the air over oil manifold, the air is actually going to be pushing through that port, then pushing into this hole, and then it's going to come out the outlet. Now let's take a look at how the manifold accomplishes that. The air over oil manifold really is just a simple manifold. It's one piece of aluminum. It's got a black paint job. It's got 4 places that can be used as the air inlet. This one isn't plugged because we're going to use it, but there's 4 places there as an air inlet. When we flip it over, we can see that we have 6 banjo bolts. One of them's in my hand. They have a hole in the side that allows the air to flow in, and then it flows out the bottom. This is what actually pushes the air into the indicator ports on the MSP valve. And then from there, the air just runs steadily into your bearing. The typical application for these would be to replace a circulating oil system. Circulating oil has been used in the past and currently as well to keep bearings cool and to clean the bearings. The oil's collected, it gets filtered, and then it gets recirculated. But eventually the oil wears out, then it has to be disposed, and that costs money. So air over oil manifolds can be used to use a terminating oil system. Instead of having all that oil to recirculate, you just push droplets of oil and your airstream keeps positive pressure in the bearing so that the bearing stays clean and cool. And then the oil doesn't have to be recollected. You just keep pushing new air into the bearing, and the oil is just a terminating oil system that doesn't have to be recollected and filtered and then eventually disposed. So that's what the air over oil manifold was designed to do. But what I've found is if we combine this with some spray nozzles, like our part number 562994, for instance, then we can use this to spray oil onto things like chains and other moving parts that want to have oil sprayed on them. And one of the big keys is that we can do it with a G3 pump. Let's take a look at how we do that. To mount the air over oil manifold, we need a nice flush surface, no cross port bars, nothing making any of the valves pop out, and then we need to remove the indicator plugs to give the manifold a place to mount. The manifold simply attaches with these banjo bolts. See if I can get these fingers started. And then you just need a 9/16 wrench to tighten it all down. With all of the banjo bolts firmly attached, now I can attach my airline and turn on the air. Here we can see a complete system. We've got three 10S valves mounted behind the air over oil manifold. We have some 3/16 OD nylon tubing connected with some compression fittings. And then at the other end, those three things that look like compression fittings are the 562-994 SG2 spray nozzles. They mount on a 1/8 inch NPT thread, so you can make your own bracket for them and spray whatever you want to spray. Let's actually see it in action now. And again, this is an E-series pump, but this same system can work off of a G3 or G1 pump and many other oil pumps. It'll take a second for some of the oil to work its way down the line. And here comes the oil. Let's get a little closer look at that. Here's a closer look where we can see it's a pretty narrow spray pattern. You can kind of see the oil misting right out of the nozzle, and we're getting quite a bit of oil now. That was only about 25 PSI. Let's try this again with 50 PSI and see if it makes a difference. It's a much finer mist, and our spray pattern may have tightened up a little bit, but it's not a huge difference. Two of our nozzles are kind of parallel to each other, so we're getting one big puddle and one small one. But that happened the same on the 25 PSI run as well. What we just saw is great if you need at least 3 points. If you know about divider valves, you know that you need to have at least 3 working sections with pistons in them, which means you need at least 3 divider valves. And that means if you want less than 3 outlets, you need to cross port. But one of the keys to the manifold is that it has to sit flush on the MSP valves. So as soon as you put a cross port on here, one of these valves is going to stick out too far, and then it won't all sit flush. The trick to get around that is to use cross port bars combined with a singling plate. Here I have 3 5T valves and a cross port both on this valve, another cross port both behind this valve, and then there's a singling plate that we offer. A lot of people aren't familiar with that, but singling plates are used at a lot of plants that like to keep stock of MSP valves but don't want to have to keep both T and S valves in stock. So they just stock all T valves, and then they use a singling plate behind here to change it into a single outlet setup. And that's what I've done here. The cross port bolt from this 5T forces all the oil down to this one, but then there's another cross port bolt here that forces all the oil down to the final 5T. And then finally, the singling plate behind there is what gets you down to one outlet, which is what we have over here. Now you can see there's the end of the singling plate and the right side of each of the cross port bolt bars. We get a nice flush surface, and now we can put our manifold back on and spray from just a single point. And there you have it, folks, our complete oil spray system. And I know I've said it a couple of times already, this demo panel uses a little E-series pneumatic pump, but you can also do this with one of the G-series oil pumps, either a G3 or a G1. The big key is really to have the spray nozzle 562-994. Those are good because they mount on a pipe thread, so it's a very common thread, and you can easily build your own bracket for those. And then the air over oil manifold for MSP, which supplies the air to those spray nozzles so that they can act as a sprayer instead of just a drip system. Hopefully you found this informative and helpful. If you have any questions, please contact us. We are always happy to hear from you. Thanks.